Good morning, Calvert Hall. I'm Justin Brickline. Today is March 30th, a day one on your schedule. We begin today with an Easter message from the Calvert Hall Campus Ministry. Please remove any distractions as we begin in prayer.
Good morning. Today, we gather virtually as a Calvert Hall community to reflect on the Lenten season as we begin Holy Week. This week, the Church observes the Passion, Death, and Resurrection of Jesus Christ in special ways through prayer, fasting, and attending Mass. Today, we join in the global Church community in remembering Jesus' sacrifice for each of us. Over the past 5 weeks, we've also explored the concept of rerouting through our Lenten Small Groups program. This unique year has offered us the opportunity to see the detour as a blessing and to seek direction from God. As we approach our spring break, may we pause and reflect, mindful of the blessings of the Easter season and the joy of the resurrection we wait for.
A reading from the Gospel according to Mark. When they drew near to Jerusalem, to Bethphage and Bethany at the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village opposite you, and immediately on entering it, you will find a colt tethered on which no one has ever sat. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone should say to you, 'Why are you doing this?' reply, 'The master has need of it and will send it back here at once.' So they went off and found a colt tethered at a gate outside on the street, and they untied it. Some of the bystanders said to them, 'What are you doing, untying the colt?' They answered them just as Jesus had told them to, and they permitted them to do it. So they brought the colt to Jesus and put their cloaks over it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut from the fields. Those preceding him, as well as those following, kept crying out, 'Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the kingdom of our father, David, that is to come. Hosanna in the highest.' He entered Jerusalem and went into the temple area. He looked around at everything, and since it was already late, went out to Bethany with the 12." The Gospel of the Lord.
It is no surprise that, like most things this past year, Holy Week looks a little different. While we are unable to join together to celebrate Mass in the theater, we gather today virtually to reflect on the Lenten season and how we may see Jesus as an example in faith and hope in God. This Lent, we use the Lenten Small Group program to try to make sense of this question of direction. The COVID-19 pandemic has affected each of our directions and caused us to reevaluate where we are going by seeking direction from God. If you are like me, you probably experienced a little bit of doubt in God's plan. When COVID began, my JV golf season was cut short. I couldn't see my friends and I wasn't sure when things would get back to normal. My direction for sophomore year was certainly changed, and I experienced a pretty big detour. It's hard to know that things will be all right during the worst parts of the year, but in this season of Lent, we are reminded that we can also look at the example of Jesus Christ to remind ourselves of God's plan. In the Gospel of Mark, the story of Jesus and his ministry take a sharp turn during the celebration of Passover. After nearly 3 years of gaining followers, working miracles, and preaching the good news of the kingdom of God, Jesus Christ entered the town of Jerusalem and was welcomed as a king. The people of Jerusalem laid down palm fronds and their cloaks and chanted, "Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." In just a few days' time, Jesus was betrayed by his apostle Judas, denied by his apostle Peter, and sentenced to death by the people who once welcomed him like a king. In many ways, our experience of the past year is similar. We've had so much of our comfortable, well-established lives changed without notice or reason. But we can take comfort in the fact that Jesus is with us in our suffering because he has lived it alongside of us. Jesus knows our confusion because he has lived it himself. And the resurrection reminds us that God can make all things new. May each of us in the Easter season believe the good news of resurrection of Jesus Christ and know and trust in God's plan for each of us.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For our church, that we may continue to lead by Christ's loving example to care for the poor and vulnerable. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who have been rerouted, that this Lent may give them rest and a new direction. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who seek God's grace, that they may experience the sacrament of reconciliation with renewed depth to taste the infinite mercy of God. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That in the light of Christ's victory over death, nations may work together to overcome violence against all, especially the poor, the weak, and the unborn. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the sick, the suffering, and those who have asked us to pray for them, especially those suffering from COVID-19, that they may know the healing power of God, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those that we hold in the silence of our hearts, that God may hear and answer them, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, amen. Lord God, we thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through his death and resurrection, we are given hope and life. We praise you in this season of resurrection and rejoice in the truth that you make all things anew, even when the road takes unexpected turns. Give us the graces to follow you even closer in this Easter season. Good and gracious God, we thank you for these and all blessings we experience in our lives today. St. John Baptist de La Salle, pray for us. Love Jesus in our hearts forever.
Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
General, classes. With additional students today, there are a very small number of classes which may be over capacity. In this case, your teacher may ask someone to go to the aux gym for class. This should only happen on rare occasions. Teachers will rotate students if this is necessary. Consequently, if you have already been to the aux gym for a class and a teacher asks you to go to another class, please tell the teacher you have already done this so another student can be asked to go to the aux gym. Dining hall. With more students in the building this week, the dining hall is only for students actively eating lunch periods 2 through 7. If the period is busy and all seats in the dining hall are full, please move to the lower plaza tent to eat. Additionally, to avoid congestion in the dining hall, we will have an auxiliary food station in the plaza tent during periods 4 through 6, serving pizza and chicken tenders. If both areas are full, students may eat in the practice field tent only on periods where there are not seats available in the dining hall. Dress code. Hair should not be excessively bushy, touch the eyebrows, or the collar of your shirt. All students should get a haircut over the break. Detention will be assigned for violations when we return. Mission drive, last call. Help support the LaSallian mission in Africa by donating to the mission drive. Cash donations will still be accepted today in the religion office. Thank you to all who have generously supported the drive to date. Schedule. Break begins at dismissal today. Half-credit courses and faculty office hours will not be held tomorrow. Enjoy your break. As a reminder, CHC will be virtual the Monday-Tuesday we return from spring break, April 12th and 13th. All classes will be held via Teams on those days. Student parking. Only seniors with permits are allowed to park on campus. If you are not a senior with a permit and are parking on campus, you will receive 5 days of detention when caught. Underclassmen should have street parking stickers and park on the street. Please contact Ms. Morris in the Student Activities Office if you need to update your parking or register a car. Why read the week ahead? Because you could have entered the free Orioles ticket raffle from yesterday's student email and won 2 tickets to 4 games at Camden Yards this summer, like sophomore Evan Levasseur. How did Evan win? All students who entered were assigned a random number, and head varsity baseball coach, Mr. Eckerl, chose the number 3, his old baseball uniform number. Congratulations, Evan. Keep reading the week ahead email. Seniors, retreat day. Seniors who want to participate in our senior retreat day on April 28th need to pre-register online ASAP. Please log into the CHC website and find the link on the Class of 2021 Roadmap to Graduation resource tile. It's going to be a great day with food, reflection, and more. Athletics. Sale. The Calvert Hall Spring Sports Under Armour Athletic Sale is now live. Deadline to place orders is April 4th. Please visit the school athletics page and click on the Under Armour Team Gear link. Today's sports schedule. Varsity baseball at Gilman, 4 o'clock away, 2 o'clock early dismissal. JV baseball versus Gilman, 4 o'clock home. JV golf at Loyola, 3 o'clock away at Pine Ridge, 1:30 early dismissal. That's all for us today, Calvert Hall. Have a great day. As always, use the remaining time in homeroom to check your email.